Welcome everyone. This video shows the colorized scenes I have done from this amazing TV series from 1965, The Adventures of Robinson Crusoe. I remember being so impressed with this show as a 12-year-old, and I have to admit I still love it now, together with its amazing soundtrack. I have done some colorizations of some scenes, which was very difficult to do as the original footage is poor quality. The series was 13 half-hour episodes, so it was difficult to pick which scenes to do. I hope you enjoy it. And if you've not watched the full series before, I thoroughly recommend it.
So today is September 16th, 1697. September 1697. One of the ship's sailors. Oh, he isn't a pretty sight. Almost unrecognizable. I was lucky. My God, I was lucky. The ship's disappeared completely. Not even any wreckage left. They can't all be dead. There must be other survivors of the shipwreck. They can't be very far. They'll answer me. I knew there were other swimmers as good as I in the crew. They must have come ashore further down. All I have to do is walk along the shore and I'll find them. The most important thing is to gather all the survivors together. My first night in this unknown country went well. I tried to piece together what happened. My ship was going from Brazil to Africa when it was caught in a storm which lasted several days and nights. As well as I can judge, the shipwreck took place off the coast of South America. But it's very possible that I'm wrong. Were all my companions drowned? Am I the sole survivor? A man's footprints. I was wrong to give up hope. I found a companion. He can't be very far. I'm not alone anymore. I'm not alone anymore. There's no time to lose my knife. The man may be a savage, who knows? I've been walking since dawn. I've found the tracks of my own footprints. I'm alone. Not one sailor from the Esmeralda has survived. This country is uninhabited. How long will I have to wait for a ship to save me? A thought occurs to me. I must find out right away, by climbing. By climbing as high as possible. I wasn't wrong. It is an island. I can see all around it. Not a single trace of human beings. A desert island. I had set out to conquer the ocean, and it is the ocean which has made me a prisoner. Oh, God. Why did you rescue me, if only to abandon me on a desert island? Why did you save my life? Why just me and not the others? Have mercy on me, dear Lord. Don't abandon me. What irony. You've got to be abandoned on a desert island to know real solitude. A hat is floating on the sea. Am I really alone? There's the wreck of the Esmeralda. The tide must have carried it out, and strong currents brought it in again to within a few yards offshore. No answer. No sign of life on the wreck. There isn't much hope of finding one of my companions. I'd better proceed cautiously. There might still be bodies on the ship. Sharks will be drawn to the wreck, eager for a feast. I don't intend to serve as an appetizer. No surprise encounters. But I feel the wreck shifting under my feet with each wave. It could split apart at any moment. It would be stupid, after surviving a tempest, to be drowned on a beautiful day. So, eyes and ears open, and get out the first disturbing sound. life on board after all. Where's that dog? That's a good dog. There. That's right. There we go. Come on. Oh, come on. Well, stay, idiot. I must take everything, down to the last nail. In a civilized country, we are used to having all we need at our fingertips. But on a deserted island, a simple needle is 1,000 times more precious than the crown jewels. A problem. How am I going to get all this to shore? For life. It's not very wise to dive into a wrecked ship, but I need that spyglass to see ships that might pass the island. There's a large store of gunpowder aboard. It still seems dry. Not a minute to lose. I must get it. How unforgivable. I almost forgot the dog.
There we are.
I'm going to call you Dick. Dick. Here, Dick. That's right. Dick, like the dog I left behind in England. Tonight, I'm almost happy. Now, I'm king of a desert island. This comforting thought causes me to accomplish the primary duty of a king and a gentleman, to shave himself. Polly? Your name is Polly. You're now the companion of Robinson Crusoe. Ah! A poor Robinson. You understand? Robin. Poor Robin. Poor, poor Robinson. Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. It'll take a while to make myself understood, but we have all the time in the world. Finally, my prayers have been answered. Yes, I'm leaving my island, but with great regret. I arrived there a rash young man full of arrogance. I'm leaving with a sense of peace and fulfillment. This island has brought out the best in me. I owe it everything.